So today we have a few things that we have to get done. One is we have a safety meeting, and then I'll have to go with Ken. We're gonna have another meeting outside in the slough, trying to get some stuff taken care of before the rain gets here, and then also do some maintenance on our trucks. All this stuff needs to get done, and this is the perfect time to do it, so let's check it out. Start of the day, here we go. So we're out to meet with somebody from, where are they from?
What are we doing today?
Some out of wetland.
Oh, one of our community partners, the Coastal Wetlands Group. And yeah, we did a constructed wetlands project in order to help facilitate getting rid of nitrates out of the water before it goes out to the ocean. So we helped construct that with them. And now we're having a little bit of issue with it, but it's starting to breed mosquitoes and it's starting to get invasive weeds in it that's just really choking the thing out. So we're going to go out, meet with Ross. He's one of the directors there at the Central Coast Wetlands Group, and meet with him and see what we can do. Might have to bring out the big boy, have Jerry come out with the excavator and pull out these toolies. I'm not quite sure yet. Could just round it up and be done with it, but I haven't seen it for a couple of years, and so we're just going to meet out there and see exactly what's going on. So that's what we're doing today, Paul.
All right, let's go check it out.
Why is it always a Prius? So we have Ross here with the Central Coast Wetlands Group. Hey Ross, you want to tell us a little bit about what these ponds are and what they do?
Sure. We call this the Castroville Treatment Wetland.
Okay.
It's an 18-acre constructed wetland that we worked with the farmers and the landowner to build about 3 years ago.
Okay.
The water that comes into this comes from 1,000 acres of agricultural fields. It is pumped into the top of our system by the county flood control district. And then the water flows through some experimental treatment, water quality enhancement experiments, and then through an 18-acre wetland where the water is cleaned, nutrients are removed, pesticides are degraded, before that water is discharged into the natural estuarine environment we're standing next to.
Right on, right on.
The wetlands provide great habitat, they clean up the water,
yeah.
But there can also be a nuisance as far as vector control and things like that.
Right,
and so any way we can work with you to minimize that, so our wetlands are not a nuisance for the farmers and the community overall, it's a win-win.
I absolutely agree. So we have that long reach backhoe and we can just pop that stuff right out of there.
That'd be great. We'll find a place to put it. I don't know. We can figure that one out, but yeah, any way you guys can help us out, it'd be greatly appreciated.
All right, we'll get on it.
Good.
All right, so we gotta do a little bit of work on the truck, a little bit of maintenance. Got Vince here to help me out. Get it done. All right, so we just finished up, able to get the truck all fixed up, taken care of. Got to get some of our meetings done this morning, did some training with Phillip, got it all done. Nice end of the week, so until next time, take it easy.